Beat with Dr. Benita Zahn.
The numbers are startling. 1 in 4 women and 1 in 7 men will experience severe physical violence by an intimate partner in their lifetime. Now, those are the numbers from the CDC. And during the pandemic, the incidence has been on the rise. So how to prevent it? How to help those affected? Let's welcome Sarah McGoffney, Unity House's Director of Community Engagement for Domestic Violence Services. Sarah, good to see you.
Hello.
So this is a community problem. As you and I were talking just before we started the official part of this, we think of it as being behind closed doors and it's their problem. But it's much bigger than that, isn't it?
Yes, absolutely. This is a huge community problem. And right now, in a time of COVID, where people are at home, not leaving, not interacting with a lot of different resources available in the community. This is something that neighbors, friends, and family, it's so important that they're active bystanders now more than ever. Now at a time where people are in their homes behind closed doors, the people who have access to them are going to be their neighbors. It's going to be the people living in the apartment below them, the people living in the house next door, the parents who are both doing homeschooling and distance learning.
Mm-hmm. But that's kind of not the way we are as a society. We do this, you know, you avert your eyes, it's their problem. And there's fear of getting involved too.
Absolutely. And it's scary to get involved. It can be dangerous. I think everyone needs to trust their instincts before getting involved in a situation. Call the police. You can call the police and report anonymously. You don't have to give your name. You don't have to give any of that information, but it is worth it to call the police, even if they get 10 phone calls. If you hear something going on, you never think, oh, well, someone else will call the police. You should call. You make that call if it's severe enough. If you don't think it's severe enough and you feel comfortable that you would see the who you determined to be a victim in a private situation where you can just check in. It's always okay to just check in with somebody. Hi, my name's Sarah. I'm your neighbor and I heard something going on last night. Are you okay? Do you need a ride? Do you need resources? This is the domestic violence hotline. Maybe they can help you.
But it's Sarah, let me jump in for a sec, because I always thought, based on what I've read, that in that interchange, the victim can be put at even greater risk. So
yes.
How do we support but not raise the risk for the victim?
Right. So you can potentially put the victim in more danger. For instance, if you give them a pamphlet and say, here's a domestic violence pamphlet, go call this person. But if you're owning that, saying you heard it and doing it in a very private way, so somewhere where you feel that the victim is alone and safe to talk to you, you don't even need to go into detail. It's good enough to say, I'm here if you need anything. Is everything okay? Just checking in. It's so important to be an active bystander and a support. We don't want to put that victim in more risk.
Right.
So we don't want to storm over when the victim is maybe with family, with potential perpetrator or their children. We really want to try, if you're going to intervene yourself, do it in a way that the victim is alone and do it in a really gentle, very trauma sensitive way, because this can be a scary time. The worst thing that's going to happen is the victim may, out of trauma, say, I don't want your help. I don't know what you're talking about. Mind your own business. But you have the potential to save someone's life. So asking if someone's okay and saving their life potentially is worth taking the risk of potentially mm-hmm. getting a mind your own business or feeling a little embarrassed, but always do that in a safe way.
If someone is watching now and they are in a dangerous situation, is there sort of the 1, 2, 3 ABC that they should do in order to get out of that?
If somebody is watching right now and is in a dangerous situation, I want to encourage them that they can call our hotline or talk to any of our staff at any time. At the domestic violence program, even if they don't live in Rensselaer County, even if they live in Albany County, Schenectady County, it doesn't matter where they live, we're going to help them. It is the most dangerous time for a victim when they're leaving an unsafe situation. So doing that with help and support systems is so important. So I encourage them to please call the hotline and come up with an individualized plan for them and their family to keep them safe.
Mm-hmm. And Sarah, what's the hotline? I'm going to link to it so that folks can see it. But in case somebody's in a situation that they don't feel comfortable going to the internet, the hotline is 1-800.
No, it's 518.
Oh, 518. Okay.
518-272-2370.
Say it one more time.
518-272-2370.
It may just be the phone call that saves their life and the life of their children if they are in that situation. Sarah McGoffney, thank you so very much. The Unity House Director of Community Engagement for Domestic Violence Services, one person at a time. Thank you. And thank you, too, for joining us. And for more information on domestic violence or if you need help, as I mentioned, I'm going to post the number and also the web address for Unity House right here on the link section at WNYT.com. We'll see you next time.